In this illustration, we'll discuss about a reaction induced by alpha particle. Here we are given that an alpha particle with kinetic energy k initiates a nuclear reaction where alpha particle attacks on beryllium and a neutron moves out and the residual nucleus is of carbon with the energy yield q. Here we are required to find the kinetic energy of the neutron outgoing at right angles to the motion direction of alpha particle. And we are given with the masses of these all particles in the reaction. Here in solution, first all of you need to understand the way how we are writing the equation. This is a reaction which is written in the form Be alpha N and C. Here whenever a nuclear reaction is written in this form, such reactions are called induced reactions, where when the first particle inside the bracket attacks on this outside particle, the second particle inside the bracket moves out and the residual nucleus is of this particle. This is the way how an induced nuclear reaction is written, in which this is the particle which we call the induction particle. In this situation, we are given that on this beryllium nucleus, an alpha particle is fired. And say if alpha is fired with the velocity v alpha, and after reaction a neutron ejects out in the direction right angle to the initial motion of alpha, which is at vn, and the remaining nucleus is of carbon, and obviously to conserve momentum carbon would be moving in this direction with the velocity vc, say at an angle theta. So, in y as well as x direction, if we consider this as x and this as y direction, as no external force is acting on the system, total momentum of system will remain conserved. Here we can write as no external force is there, so momentum of system remain conserved. So, in this situation for x direction, if we talk, initial momentum was m alpha v alpha, and after reaction it is mc vc cos theta. So, this is our first equation. And in y direction, we can see initially there was no momentum, so final momentum must be zero. So, we can write mn vn is equals to mc vc sin theta, that is here second equation. And these two equations, if we square and add, here we get m alpha square v alpha square plus mn square vn square is equals to mc square vc square. Say this is our third equation. And if we use energy conservation, here we can write by conservation of energy, we have initial energy of alpha particle was half m alpha v alpha square, and the released energy in the reaction is q. So we can add this q. This must be the final energy of the particle. So it is half m n v n square plus half m c v c square. Say this is our equation 4. From equation 3, we can substitute the value of Vc square in this, because we are required to find the kinetic energy of neutron that we can get from here. This is the kinetic energy of alpha particle, which is already given to us as k plus q is half mn vn square. We can write as kn, we are required to calculate, plus this is half mc. And Vc square can be substituted from equation 3. Here we can write from equation 3, we substitute the value of Vc square. It is m alpha square v alpha square plus mn square vn square divided by mc square. So here one mc gets cancelled out, and remaining term we can substitute in terms of k and kn. So this becomes k plus q is equals to kn plus this half. You can see m alpha v alpha square can be written as k. So this is k multiplied by m alpha by mc plus this term half mn vn square we can write as kn multiplied by mn upon mc. Now simplifying this expression, we can get the value of kn, which we are required to find the kinetic energy of neutron, and this gives us q plus k multiplied by 1 minus m alpha by mc divided by 1 plus mn by mc. So this is the final result of this problem.